Hey, Railbirds, Kevin here. All right, up next we have Carlo Beato versus Bernie Petipice. Well, let me get that scoreboard updated here. There we go. We're up to date now. All right, thanks for watching our coverage of the 2019 Derby City Classic. Some one pocket going on today. These matches brought to you by Diamond Billiard Products, BilliardShoppingNetwork.com, and us, Railbirds Productions. Thanks for watching today. Remember to hit that thumbs up, subscribe, ring that bell. If you don't ring that bell, you won't get notified when we go live and when we upload new videos. Remember to share. Sharing's caring. And if you like what we do, consider a small monthly contribution at patreon.com. Helps keep our coffee cups full and the live streams coming. Everybody knows live streamers run on coffee. Also, if you wish to contribute $5 or more, you will get a free autographed Sky Woodward photo. Sky Woodward, 2018 Moscone Cup MVP. Looks like players are still warming up. I thought they were ready to go. That was my mistake. They're not ready to go. So we'll just sit back and let them shoot some balls for a minute or two. I think while they warm up, this might be a good time for me to go refresh my drink. Actually, before I do that, I'm just going to go over the rules real quick for you guys. So we're playing some Derby City rules, one pocket. It's going to be alternate break, rack your own. First person to make eight balls in their pocket wins that game. It's pretty standard one pocket rules. But we are playing, if you make a ball on a break in your pocket, that will be a re-rack and you break again. And three foul rule is in effect. All right, here we go. We're getting started now. Here comes the lag. All right, that's Carlo on the right, Bernie on the left. Hey, down in front. All right, Carlo's gonna win that lag. All right, Carlo with the break. It's not a bad break. He almost made a ball in his pocket. Had that nine gone, I think that's a nine. That would have been a re-rack. But balls didn't really spread out real well. They're still only a four balls came out, really. 3, suck that cue ball into the stack. Bank the 2, suck the cue ball into the stack. Kick that ball in, that's hanging in the pocket. Can't tell if that's the 9 or the 13. I'm going to try to billiard it. Looks like he's going for the billiard. All right, successful billiard. No, he scratched. All right, so Bernie gonna owe a ball. Carlo coming to the table with ball in hand in the kitchen. At Derby City, the rules for whether a ball's in the kitchen or not are a little bit different than what you might be used to. At Derby City, they do not play the base of the ball. They play the entire ball must be 100%, the entire cue ball must be 100% behind the line. And any ball you're shooting at must be 100% ahead of the line, outside of the kitchen. So they do not go by the base of the ball, they go by the entire ball. How's that 4-3 combination looking? Or 2-3, whatever that is. I'm having a hard time telling the colors today. Sorry, everyone. Well, it's looking pretty good. All right, straight in on this ball. Roll down, bank that stripe. Actually, I'm going to turn off the chat on screen because it's blocking the pocket, so I'm going to have to turn that off. Alright, did I miss anything? Is the ball count right? Let's see. 2, 3, 4 by 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Wait. Are there only 10 balls out there? If so, then I'm way off on the count. Okay, there's 11 balls out there plus. Okay, Carlo has 4. All right. Pot's right. Oh no, the deck come out. Does he have a shot? I think he's got a shot. Nice shot. Good line on the cue ball. But he's, you know, a little bit on the wrong side of this four. I don't know if he has any angle we can follow. Maybe he may shoot this six, this 2-6 combination right now. Nope. Yeah, he's pretty straight on this four, so we're looking at shoot the four, bank the two next. Oh, you gotta hit the ball. Gotta hit the ball, Carlo. So I do have the ball count right, right? 6-1. I think that's right. Now, can you shoot the five ball off of the six, where you send the five at your pocket and leave the cue ball in the stack? Is that available? Or is that six in there a little too deep to play the five off of it towards your pocket? I think that's what he's shooting at. He's going to try to move the five to his pocket off the six. Uh-oh. Disaster. And he's not even going to make him shoot him. I believe Carlo needed two from there. He didn't need just that one that was hanging, but so he's going to give him to him anyway. All right, 1-0, Carlo versus Bernie in this race to three. All right, Bernie with the break. All right, he's going to be shooting at that pocket. Let me swap the names around. All right, those balls opened up really nice. Thank you. All right, how are we getting out of this break? Intentional foul, kick over, just kick over to that, over to Bernie's corner, up and down table. Nope, he's got something else in mind. Or even try to kick two rails at the one, end rail, side rail at the one. Looks like that's what he's doing. Either trying to go two rails at the one or just one rail at the corner. He's going two rails at the one. Is he going to get a good hit? No hit. I think Bernie's just looking at banking that stripe and following forward, leaving them hooked behind the stack again. That 9 or 13 or whatever that is. Rerail the 8. Good hit. Looks like he might have a window at that that same stripe I was talking about before, that 9 or 13. I can't tell what that stripe is. Let the cue ball go forward. Maybe even to the railing up behind the 4, possibly. Although it does look like it might hit the 2, and if you hit the 2, then probably come back and double kiss the cue ball, the stripe. All right, slowly but surely, things are starting to look a little less advantageous for Bernie. Nice shot, nice cue ball. Is this one of those shots where you can move everything in one shot, shoot that 11 into the 2 and the 2 into the 1 and everything moves? That's what he's doing. Thin off that stripe and try to get the cue ball 2 rails in behind the 4 ball. Oh, he's hitting that full. I think that's the 14. Nice shot. Oh, he found a dead ball. Nice shot there, Carlo. Not going to get much reward for it, though. Thank you. All right. How about what that 14? Bank the 14 in your pocket. Draw over to the side rail. I think that's the 14 next to the 5. No, he doesn't like it. Two rail of 3, trying to come back in behind the 4. Missing a ball somewhere here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. There's only 14 balls on the table. All right, who made a ball? So I'm off on the count here somewhere. Who has a ball that I didn't score? Good cue ball, and balls are starting to go up table. I'm starting to think this is going to be a long game. All right, chat room says Carlo has a ball. All right, thank you for that. That's one way to start getting the balls back down table, if you can do them 2 at a time like that. So chat room says Bernie has a ball. Carlo has only made 1 ball so far, but that was the one he owed for his earlier foul. All right, that's so. Are we in agreement now? Bernie has 1, Carlo has 0. So I couldn't remember Carlo making 2. I know he owed 1. I know he made the 1 where he kicked at that dead ball. Can't remember him making any other balls, but I don't remember Bernie making a ball. Did he get a rail? I think, yeah, that was a good hit. Yep, good hit. Nice shot. Hey, Clayton from Brazil, welcome back. Oh, does this have legs to get there? Oh. So close. And, yeah, no easy way for Bernie to get that ball out of there. I mean, or even to give him the ball. What are you looking at, Bernie? Can you just fire this? The eight ball at that cluster knocks the seven in, and that 10-4 and the eight all vacate the premises. Oh, he was trying to come off the four cue ball into the seven. And, well, he just put up a penny, so he did not have a ball to pay. So I'm thinking the one is, Carlo must have the one, unless I'm miscounting. Let me count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12, 13, 14. Yeah, I only count 14 out there, so Carlo must have one. Bernie just put up a penny. And yeah, so negative one to Bernie. Thank you. So you're going to roll forward for the eight, bank on the 8 or try to come back up table. Always playing position on the 8. Oh, that's a nice little shot there. He had more angle on that ball than I thought. I thought he was too straight on that ball to get in behind the 8. Just trying to tie up those balls there, trying to take away some banking lanes and trying to double them up. So didn't really turn out that way, but that's what he was attempting. Good cue ball. Does he have him corner hooked? Wow, I think he might have him on the, right on that rail. I think he's got him corner hooked from everything. That's a pro move there. Don't try that at home. Well, it's like he's doing Carlo's job for him. He's tying up his own stuff there so it doesn't go. Just going to bank to 14 out of there. He was just looking to see if he leaves the cue ball there, is he going to leave a bank for Carlo? And he's decided, nope, he's okay leaving the cue ball in that vicinity. Yeah, got to stop tying up your stuff there, Bernie. Got to be able to make something should the opportunity arise. Carlo's going to help you out. Yeah, this bank on the five is looking awfully tempting, and Bernie's tempted. Is it going to get there? Oh, nice. The suspense was killing me. I didn't know if it was going to get there. I think he's got him right on that two ball. That's a nice shot there, Bernie. Alright, just wants to leave that cue ball there. He wants to protect that 14. Thank you, Tony in the chat room. Tony in the chat room says after Carlo made the ball he owed, he banked a ball cross side and then only spotted one ball. So maybe there was an error on the part of the players. Yeah. Alex in the chat room wants to know if these players have a Fargo rating. Yes, they do. Fargo rate is not used for one pocket, so I don't bother displaying it on screen. Fargo rate doesn't even consider one pocket. Fargo rate only considers 8-ball, 9-ball, 10-ball. But I'll look him up real quick anyway, just because. Carlo Beato, 809, very respectable Fargo rate. That's basically one of the best in the world. Anything over 800 is very elite territory. And Bernie, 697. Which sounds kind of anticlimactic after hearing that 809 for Carlo, but 697 is still very respectable. It's basically 700, and that's a very strong player. 700 is a very strong player. All right, while I was looking that up, did anybody make a ball? Is the score still right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Plus 6 is 15. So, all right. The pot's right. Gonna double him up, still protecting that 14. Nice shot there. Nice shot there, Bernie.
Next match names on table 20 is Omar Al-Sheen and Jason Shaw.
And if Carlo wanted to, he could shoot the two at the 14 to try to move both of those balls out of there. May even take a slice at this. I think it's the 11. And if he can protect the cue ball to not sell out a shot if he misses, that would be. Then that's what he's going to shoot at. And that's what he's doing. He's bringing the cue ball down to not leave a shot on the 14. And all right, has not left a shot. Thank you. DiCarlo wants to shoot. He's just going to play safe. Just thin, cue ball to the end rail. Nice touch. That's nice what he did with those balls there, because they both go to Carlos' pocket, but they don't go to Bernie's pocket. So, nice touch. Balls are going up table, and had no choice but to let Carlos see that 14, and Carlos going to waste no time removing that 14 from Bernie's area of the table. Well, I think it was a half hour ago or 20 minutes ago I said this could be a long game, and there's still 9 balls on the table, and it's not looking like it's going to end anytime soon. Good effort at the three railer. Found a nice little, found a path through all the traffic. Did he leave a bank on this three? No, a bank on whatever that stripe is. 12, I think. As I said, I'm having a hard time seeing the colors today, so I'm calling them wrong, I'm sure, the colors, the balls. Oh, nice shot there, Bernie. All Would have loved for that cue ball to stop just 6 inches sooner. Then he'd have a much easier bank, and then he could hold it for the 14 next if he makes the bank. Now the cue ball's going to be going a little bit wild if he goes for this bank. Just bank to 12 straight across. Just bank it straight across to your side of the table. I'm not trying to make it, just straight across, leave them kind of doubled up on the 14-12, but nope, doesn't want to take the chance of leaving a bank for Carlo. Just moving the balls up table, leaving a cue ball frozen to the end rail, protecting your lead. Don't start making a wedge over there. Actually, may have left a bank on this five. Carlos putting a lot of spin on it, trying to twist it and hold that cue ball, and that's a fantastic shot. Nice cue ball, too, on that shot. Very nice. There we go. Game number two. 2-0 in this race to three. Looks like Bernie's going to go take his break. And at Derby City, practice is allowed while your opponent's on break. Players are going to take a quick break, and so am I. So I'll be back in just a minute. Here's a back from break. Yeah, this is kind of like Carlo's first break where they don't really spread out very good. Bernie had a much nicer spread on his break. And he'll swap the names around because Carlo is shooting at that left corner. Bernie's shooting at the right corner. Come off the edge of that stripe that's sticking out of the stack there. Cue ball to the bottom rail and then behind that. Was that 12-7? And I think that's the 14. Thin off the 14, cue ball two rails in behind the 12. Or is he banking to six? He might be banking to six back in his pocket. He is, and that's not going to go, but it's hanging up in the jaws. Carl's just going to pocket this six, try to get the cue ball on the stack. Just like so. Thin off the stack, just send the cue ball up table, up near that upper right corner on screen. He's looking at that. I'm not sure what he's looking at. I think he might have been looking at that 714 or 712, whatever that is over there, 7, whatever that cluster is. And I think he's perfectly happy just leaving it as is because it blocks Carlo's pocket. It doesn't go and it prevents anything else from going. Well, anything from up table going. Just thin off at cue ball up table. Take the easy route. Nice. Definitely got something else in mind. What you got in mind here, Bernie? That was interesting. Can you cheat the pocket? You know, does that one go? You might shoot the one. And even if it doesn't go, maybe it'll just kind of hang up there in the jaws. You have to cheat the pocket, let it go to the rail a little. Oh, no, it goes. Nice shot there. Yeah, that's not a bad result. At least it opens those up, and he's got them blocked by the stack, so that's not bad. In fact, you might even argue that that's better than actually making the ball clean without touching anything. Wow, nice shot there, Bernie. That was a nice shot. Nice cue ball. Yeah, just jack up and blast at him. Well, hey, that works too. Is Carl going to try to get him two rails on the stack? Yes, he is. Oh, nice shot. He's got him frozen on that ball. Can't even see the four. Says this cue ball's in such a tough spot, I'll just let Carlo shoot at it. Got a nice little brush there off the stack. Looks to me like he can just cross this six up towards the four. Cue ball stays on the bottom rail. No, he wants to move them both. Ooh, good cue ball. And he's got both balls over back towards his side of the table. Nice shot. Very nice shot. Carlo's just going to stick him on the stack. No, he's drawn back to the end rail. I'm sensing another up-table game coming on here. Oh, look at this shot. Oh, that was nice, nice effort there. And Carlo can't even see it to knock it out of there. He's going to have to kick at it. Jay wants to know who won the Bustamante and Richardson match. Boosty won that one. 3-0, I believe. Bank to five, back to your side of the table, and let the cue ball roll forward, protecting the three. Shooting at the 14-3 combination. If you don't make it, you're pushing balls towards Carlo's pocket. I don't like that. Yeah, that was fraught with peril. Well, I thought this might turn into another up-table game, but I'm thinking not. All right, he says that's good. All right, thank you guys for watching. Carlo does defeat Bernie. This was round two action. All right, we still have plenty more one pocket coming up tonight. So stick around, and thanks for watching, and we'll be right back.